Welcome back to
the Dickinson Adventures. I'm Robbie.
And I'm Tay.
And we back.
And today we're going to be talking about a few of the challenges on our farm for winter season. The first thing that we wanted to talk about are the plants. I am the gardener out here. So during the winter time, we've had a few issues with our leaves like dying off, like getting like this brown stuff on them, and just being frozen because we haven't been used to having like 30 degree weather out here. If you don't know, we are off grid, so it's kind of hard to keep everything warm when we don't have any connection to the power grid.
There are a few things that we do have. We use solar panels, which we have a solar refrigerator, we have solar lights, and we have wind turbines that we're going to connect for this year. And we also have about three generators each pulling off a different amount of water, so whatever one we need for which situation. So we are off grid, but we still do have ways to get our power, y'all.
Yeah, and another challenge has been the animals for winter time. We have lost a few chickens to hypothermia, but we used those chickens and buried them by our banana tree, so that could be a good thing if you lose any smaller animals, use them for fertilizer. But just trying to keep the smaller animals warm, keep our bigger animals warm, they've been fine. Basically, that's it.
Yeah, like you say, enclosures, you guys, make sure your enclosures are together as much as possible. I mean, you can only do what you can do because, like I say, some of the chickens were hypothermia. One of them I seen was just squished. So if they cold and huddling up and getting together, and they're weak or they're at the bottom, chances are, not every time, but it can happen where they can like kind of squeeze them to death, suffocate them, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, that's one of the problems that we had. And between the vegetation and the animals, the biggest problems that we had was our two donkeys.
Oh yeah. I don't know why. Well, because there hasn't been sun out here, our solar panel hasn't been charging as much. So we have them on an electrical fence, and the electrical fence wasn't getting enough sun, so it wasn't shocking them. So we had to, well, before we did all that changing, we did the changing because the donkeys ate all of our vegetables along the edge of the garden. I'm not gonna lie. I came home, I saw all my hard work just gone. I just cried. when you get so invested into things and you're doing it for your family, and you're trying to make sure that you're doing the best thing possible, and you come home and see all of your work just gone, like, it could be a really emotional thing.
Yeah,
so we had to change our fencing around and do some different things to keep the donkeys away from our vegetation.
Yeah, and now the fence is on if you touch me, you might pass out, okay?
Yeah, and we've just been loving it. Anything else about the animals?
With the animals, no, just like I say, making sure that you have the enclosures together, because that's one of the biggest things, even with our tractors. Make sure you have a tarp or something that you can use to fully cover at least the back end and the back of it as much as possible, so that the wind doesn't draft through so much. And just making sure that it's secure enough to keep them away from all the different elements, the rain, the other animals like foxes or something that might try to get into their enclosure. But for this winter, yes, our biggest challenge was just the warmthness. And you know, this is Florida, so we're not even supposed to be like this. Like, I'm
right.
It's been 30s and 20s. The lowest we were was about 23.
Yeah. One of those nights last week. Yeah, it was very cold.
And a lot of our vegetation didn't die from the cold, but certain things like tomatoes.
Yeah.
Our banana trees went down a little bit. Our more flowers went down stuff like our strawberries, our lettuces and cabbages and kales, they're still growing, the ones that the animals didn't eat.
Yeah.
So yeah, okay. Not everything dies out. And then like I say, just know your seasons. If you're in the winter time, get some winter stuff, like the mm-hmm. winter lettuce and the winter squashes and things of that nature, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some of the lessons that we learned from this winter season that we hope to put in action for next winter. The first thing is our energy, making sure that we have like a supply of gas for our generators, like building it up all year, so that we have a reserve during winter time. Also building up like our propane.
Like I say, solar panels, I have a few of them hooked up, and I do have the deep well battery. So like I say, just investing in more things to help out, more deep cycle batteries, deep well mm-hmm. batteries, so that we can charge them and just leave them off, so that when we need them, we can plug them up and use them how we need to. Finding ways to make things work together, like propane generator, not just a gas generator, so something that might have something extra in it that we can use more than one way to supply the energy that we need for our housing and our animals.
Yeah. I can't think of anything else.
Nope, me either, y'all.
You know what? I can think of something else. Like I was saying, it is winter time. We hope that you see this video before it warms up, because a lot of people do not know that you need to be building your immunity during this time. So I just want to give you all just a quick little secret little recipe really quick for a natural cough syrup. Yes,
natural.
And to do this natural cough syrup, you only need 4 ingredients. All right, 1, you will need onions. 2, you will need lemons. And 3, you will need garlic. Yes. Yes.
I thought you said 4.
The last thing that you're going to need is honey. Thank you.
Honey, lemon, garlic.
Yes,
onion. Is that a chicken wing flavor? What's going on?
No, what you want to do is you want to chop up all of your onions, your garlic, and your lemon.
How well do you need to chop it?
It doesn't have to be finely minced. Okay. Yes, just enough so that you can get the benefits into your honey. You're going to want to put those 3 ingredients into the jar and then fully cover it with honey. Then, once you make that natural cough syrup, you could take that concoction 3 times a day.
3 times a day?
Up to 3 times a day. You don't have to. But if you're having problems with coughing and your throat and your chest hurt, those things will definitely bring some great relief to you.
And after you get done with your cold and getting that done, you slide it on some chicken wings that you got on the grill.
No.
And it's a good marinade.
You know what? That might be a good marinade. I might need to try that. But all you need to do, like I said, put all of those ingredients inside of a jar. You could do it inside of a mason jar, probably be best. And you want to make sure that you're refrigerating that concoction. And you can keep that concoction for months.
So last question I have about it, do you just put it all in there and then you can take it?
If you want to, you can. But I would suggest to let it sit for at least 3 days. You want all of those ingredients to get inside of the honey.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Yes, I love threes, y'all. So if you notice from most of my recipes, I do have threes in them. That's just me.
Okay. So you get this and you take a teaspoon.
Mm-hmm.
And you just shove it in your mouth.
I say tablespoon.
A tablespoon.
Yes, tablespoon.
Do you need to pick up an onion or something?
No, you don't. But if you get a little piece of onion, it's okay.
No, it ain't. Because your breath, you have a mint. Because your breath will not be on the same level as you feel.
I guess one more side tip. If you do not like it like that, just plain, you can also take that concoction and put it in a tea. And you'll have the same benefits.
Garlic and honey tea.
Garlic, honey,
onion,
lemon
onion tea.
Yes, covered in honey.
So
that's just my secret tip for you all to help you get through the winter season. It's safe for your children as long as they're at least 1 year old, because I think we're not supposed to give honey to babies.
And I have a tip for keeping warm. Put on clothes.
Yes.
You have shirts, pants, undergarments,
You do.
Socks, jackets. You can put on gloves. Just in case you don't know.
Right. Just in case your mom never taught you how to get dressed. These are a few things that you might want to put on to maintain, you know, your body temperature, mm-hmm. keep all your heat in. Mm-hmm. Those are the duckies.
These are the eaters. As you can see, they're really close to the garden area where they like to eat, especially her.
Stella. And I just want to let you all know that we will be doing animal videos. Mm-hmm. We're going to be telling you about each animal. So mm-hmm. we're going to do one video per animal just in case you all want to increase your livestock during the springtime. Mm-hmm. Or if you want to just experiment with some low maintenance animals, because we have low maintenance animals.
And in the wintertime, the last thing we forgot to say mm-hmm. is what we just kind of learned and learning while doing this is that a lot of people don't keep a whole lot of animals during the wintertime.
Right. Yeah.
They kind of sell them off, you know, processing whatever they have to do mm-hmm. to get them ready to and set up for the next season to kind of buy more animals and get them while they're at the top of the season. So
right.
To stop a lot of animal loss.
Yeah.
Before you lose them, if you don't know exactly how you're going to take care of them or what to do or something goes wrong, sell them before you lose them. At least you'll have some money, even though you might lose an attachment, but they're here to, you know, serve a purpose. So, you know, you use them, you keep them, you mm-hmm. eat them, you do whatever you have to do to kind of, like I say, make it work for you.
Before we go, we had to let you all know that our website for the year of 2022 is only $1 a month.
$1?
$1.
$1?
We're doing $1 a month all year.
Wow.
And we will be holding exclusive videos over there. We already have some of our interviews that are not here on YouTube. And we'll also be having live streaming over there. So we'll be able to live stream on our website. So you want to make sure that you are over there because there are so many things that we want to share that we cannot share on here since we've been shadow banned, if y'all didn't know.
Yeah.
So you'll be able to see all the exclusive content over there.
Yes, yes. So y'all be vigilant. That's it?
That's it.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Is that enough? Well, we just want to thank y'all for hanging along and coming back and being with us again. We're sorry it's been so long since we put something out. It's been wow, you guys. So hopefully we talk about that a little bit more on our other videos, okay? So I'm Robbie.
Hey, and I'm Tay, and we thank you for coming and watching
the Dickinson Adventures.